Guys, I'm Kasturi Sanap and I welcome you all to this video. Guys, today we are going to talk about something which has decreased the number of financial crimes or frauds that was taking place in India. It has reduced a big headache of banks. We are going to talk about CIBIL in this episode. Before the year 2000, in the year 1990s, a lot of people used to take loan from one bank, never return that loan, and then approach another bank, not do business at all with the first bank from where they had taken the loan. Similarly, they used to repeat whatever they did with bank number one with bank number two and not pay any loans. So that is how people used to default on their loans, and then RBI got into this problem and it suggested that there should be one institute which talks about the credibility, the past credibility of the borrowers, and that is how CIBIL was born in the year 2000. Today we are going to look into what exactly is a CIBIL score and how to improve your CIBIL score. So let's get started. Whenever you want to get into one of your favorite colleges, what do you require? You require a good score. Similarly, when you approach a bank and if you want a loan, then what you require is a good CIBIL score. If you have a good CIBIL score, then the bank is going to give you loan very easily, and also it will give you loan at lower interest rate. So a CIBIL score ranges from 300 to 900. Generally, a score of 750 and above is considered to be a decent CIBIL score. Now, what exactly is CIBIL? So CIBIL is an organization which stands for, the acronym CIBIL stands for Credit Information Bureau of India. What it does is it gives you the past credit information to all the lenders and bank to which you have applied for a loan. So if at all you've taken a loan from one of the banks, then when you apply to loan for another bank, with another bank, then CIBIL is going to provide that information. What are the EMIs, whether you are regularly paying your EMIs or not, if you hold any credit card, if you have any other debt on your name. So CIBIL provides all the information related to your credit activities to the bank or the lenders to which you have applied for loan. Now let's have a look at how exactly the CIBIL score is calculated. The first one is your repayment history. If at all you default on any of the EMIs, then your CIBIL score gets negatively affected. If you don't pay your credit card bills on time, then your CIBIL score declines, and a bad CIBIL score means that bank will not lend you very easily. The second important point by which CIBIL score is calculated is credit utilization. So if you have utilized all of the credit, if you have utilized all your credit card limit, that means that there is a rising debt on you. So a bank is not going to lend a person who has rising debt, because that raises concern over his repayment. So increasing credit utilization is negatively impacting your CIBIL score. The third one is credit mix. If you have a healthy credit mix of secured and unsecured loans, then that positively affects your CIBIL. And the fourth and important point is multiple inquiries. If there are various banks, there are a number of banks who are sending inquiries to CIBIL for getting your CIBIL score, that means you have applied to many banks for loans. So that can negatively impact your CIBIL score. There are four such companies. There is one interesting fact to note. CIBIL is not the only institute which is approved by RBI to share your credit information. There are in fact four other institutes other than CIBIL who are approved by RBI and who can share your credit information. But of course, CIBIL is the most popular one. So what do you guys think about this video? Post it in the comment section. Stay safe, guys. Thank you.